Hello everyone, Mike Daniels Inc. here on my newest series. We are going to be doing a dry run of Arkham Knight. I have never played this game. I played Arkham Asylum and Arkham City. So, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, this is the sequel to Arkham City. I also briefly played Arkham Origins, but I didn't really get into it as much as City and Asylum, so we're going to see how this one turns out, and when we finish this series, we will be doing a review. So, let's figure out what our plan is here. Normal difficulty is fine, hints on is fine. I always turn my brightness way up. I'm especially going to do it here just because I'm not sure how the transition to YouTube will handle it, but usually I turn my brightness all the way up anyway. I'm going to turn subtitles on so that if I end up talking over something important, you guys can kind of read what's going on as far as the text in the game is. I'm not sure how much editing I'll be doing in this series. I do plan on playing for about a half an hour at a time, or thereabouts. Basically, I'm going to play until I think it's been long enough and I find a good stopping point. And we'll go from there. So, we are going to go ahead and start here, and we'll see kind of what goes on. I wasn't sure if there was opening cinematic. Apparently there's not, as far as the before the starting the game up here, so I'm going to try and be quiet during cutscenes, though, so that you guys can hear what's going on. For some reason, this reminds me of Bioshock. I don't know why. Just like the aesthetic and the music, it makes you think of Bioshock. Anyway. I'd sacrifice anything come what might for the sake of having him near. In spite of a warning voice comes in the night and repeats in my ear. Don't you know, little fool? And this confirms that this is, in fact, a sequel to Arkham City. Use your mentality. Wake up to reality. But each time that I do, just the thought of you makes me stop. His eyes are gonna open. I can feel it. Wait for it. Oh, okay, I gotta push X to incinerate him, apparently. That's dark. Okay, there we go. Am I missing something here? Oh, there we go. I'm not sure I had to, like, hold the button, or tap the button, or what was going on. Well, that's gruesome.
This is how it happened. This is how the Batman died.
No, that's ominous.
9 months ago, Joker was cremated. I pressed the button and burnt the evil bastard myself. And then, we waited. Gotham braced itself for the inevitable power struggle. But it didn't come. Crime actually fell. Deep down, I knew war was coming.
World War III? Probably not.
I was just waiting for someone to pull the trigger.
little did we know, you play as a cop in this game. Apparently you do, briefly. I was being sarcastic.
Thanks.
No problem. Oh, thanks, honey! So, what'll it be? The usual?
Sure.
Turn my head up here.
Salad with no dressing.
No, you know what? Make it waffles. With a side of bacon. Don't tell my wife.
Whatever you say, officer. Oh, and if you want some more coffee, just shout.
Waffles with a side of bacon. Not really my, my first choice.
Hey, I'm sorry to interrupt your dinner, officer, Owens. There's a guy smoking over there. Corner booth. Wait here. I'll have a word.
Yeah, let's have a look around here, see if there's any, like, little Easter eggs or anything that I would notice. I'm not a huge DC fan, so a lot of the smaller Easter eggs referencing other superheroes I probably won't catch. And some of, like, the less known Batman villains I probably won't catch references to either. But, you know, we'll see. We'll see what I can notice. Maybe there'll be reference to the other games as well. But it's been a while since I've played Arkham Asylum and Arkham City, so does it eat me? Anyway, so we'll find out how much I actually know about Batman, I guess, in this. I feel like I know quite a bit about Batman, but I can actually find out. He is, like, probably my second favorite DC hero. So, yeah, I'm much more of a Marvel guy. And you'll probably catch that more when the new Spider-Man game comes up, because I'll be playing that on this channel as well. So, yeah, I'm just kind of looking to see who else is kind of reading. Hunt continues for corporate killer? I can zoom in, that's cool. That guy looks familiar. Could not tell you who it is, though, top of my head. I think he was in a reference to an Arkham City or Arkham Asylum, but I can't remember who that is. I could also be wrong. And here's the guy smoking in the corner. Smoking in the boys' room. Zombie! Zombies! So I'm guessing Scarecrow. Yep, this is definitely a scarecrow toxin. Oh, okay. Fantastic. This is definitely a different opening to the game than I was expecting. Huh.
This demonstration used just 5 ounces of my latest toxin.
Thanks, Scarecrow, you're scary.
This will seem like child's play. Gotham. This is your only warning.
Those are the villains that are always giving warnings. I don't get it. On the bus go round and round, round and round.
Scarecrow's threat worked. Yesterday there were 6.3 million people in Gotham City. Today, not so many.
Hmm. Sucks to be that guy.
The only people left on the streets are the sort that enjoy the chaos.
Gotham's finest.
Scum. Criminals. And worse. Not enough good people left to stop them.
I wonder if Penguin is still voiced by Nolan North in this game. I know I did the voice of him in the first two, so I'm assuming that it probably is.
It took just 24 hours for us to lose control of the city. Tonight,
well, that's because it's Gotham.
Gotham's relying on one man to save us all.
No, not Batman. We want Nightwing. We want Nightwing. Sorry. Although I think, if I remember right, I think Nightwing is in this game from what I read on Game Informer and whatever. So, yeah. Alright, well, it looks like we're finally Batman. We don't gotta get our gear this time like in the first two games. So, yeah. I'm guessing you want to go to this exclamation point right here.
Batman once broke my arm in three places, but the way I see it, lightning ain't gonna strike the same place twice.
Look out! Batman's here! Batman's always here, dude. Okay, so I kind of feel like I don't know what's going on right now, so I'm just gonna go to the next objective. There's a dude back there for me to beat up, but I kind of feel like I don't know what's going on, so let's see. Yep. That's how you run. I was trying to figure that one out. Well, Joker's dead, dude, so sucks to be you. I guess we're gonna go up, maybe? Go up here. There we go. I guess that cop is in the way. God, there's my objective. Gotcha. Alright, cool.
I'm just glad you made it out okay. Sorry, I've gotta go. Stay safe, Barbara. You still know how to make an entrance.
How's the evacuation going?
Last bus crossed the city limits an hour ago. I'm just glad my little girl got out when she did. Now the real work begins.
Any lead on Scarecrow?
We were tracking an unknown military vehicle speeding through Chinatown. It's the only lead we've had all night, but they gave us the slip. With the evacuation, I just don't have the manpower left in the city.
If you find it, tell your men not to engage. I'll deal with it.
Do you really think Scarecrow's crazy enough to detonate a chemical weapon in Gotham?
I won't let that happen to you. In case you need to reach me, it's going to be a long night.
All units, we've got a 1033 in Sector 2. Missing a patrol car. Unit 247, suspected officer down.
Hey, Batman. Every damn time.
Oracle, I need the location of Unit 247.
Already working on it. How's my dad doing?
He's holding up.
Somehow, he always does. Okay, I'm sending through the squad car's location. Be careful. It's not looking good out there.
Okay, so I'm gonna take a little bit while I'm going to the next objective. I'm trying to kind of guesstimate how this is going to work as far as the editing of this goes and what have you. At least for like the beginning parts of the game while I'm kind of exploring Gotham a little bit, I might actually show just about everything there is to show you guys. But judging by the fact that this game is pretty old, I'm sure that most people have probably already played this game. So I might skip a lot of the traveling from objective to objective, just for the sake of time and not having unnecessary stuff. On the episodes. So with that said, the longer this goes, probably the less and less I'm gonna show of just the general stuff. But I'm guessing. Okay, so it is basically exactly like City and Asylum was as far as the combat goes. So I'm assuming eventually I'll meet guys who have, like,
I could use some help here.
Could you use help? Yeah, that's what I was looking for. There we go, this guy. Hello, dude.
You're safe.
Thanks, Batman. I thought they were gonna kill me.
That was a little unnecessary.
The city's overrun. We don't stand a chance.
Stay here. I'll send someone to pick you up.
What are you doing?
Evening the odds.
I'm guessing Batmobile? Yep. So yeah, as the game goes on more, I'll probably skip more and more of, like, the traveling to and from quest objectives and stuff like that. I don't plan on doing a complete 100% run of the game. I'm just gonna play through it until I beat it and do whatever I feel like doing in the process, and we'll go from there. So, yeah, I mean, I'm really looking forward to this game, wanting to play it since it came out, basically.
Pull off your men, Jim.
And, yeah.
Gordon, I'm calling off the pursuit. It's too dangerous.
Sir, we're right here. We can take these bastards.
What the? They just fired an RPG at us.
Who the hell are these guys?
5-6, pull back now. That's an order. Let Batman deal with it.
Directed from an RPG. They're gone, sir.
Please, Batman, you've got to stop them.
Don't worry, Jim. He's mine.
Wow. This is gonna take some getting used to.
We need to interrogate the driver and find out what he knows.
Oh, I guess I gotta go over here.
Where's Scarecrow?
Go to hell!
Where are the drugs? Sorry, that was...
Where is he?
I got nothing to say to you, Batman.
Talk, or I'll crush every bone in your body.
Okay, okay! He's working out of a penthouse in Chinatown. I swear that's all I know!
Damn, he's going all Christian Bale at Batman on this dude.
I'll break the other one.
The other one?
Sword on.
Check
oh, sorry.
Analysis I've just uploaded.
Sure. Is this what I think it is?
Scarecrow's new toxin. An uncontaminated sample.
You're not kidding. I'll prepare a full chemical breakdown on the back computer. What are you going to do?
Scarecrow's got a safe house nearby. I'm going to pay him a visit.
Let's hope this is the break we've been waiting for.
Investigate Scarecrow's safe house. Okay. Oh, that seems like a lot of fun that I don't want to have. Scarecrow was one of the more annoying bosses in the first two games. So I'm assuming he's probably pretty annoying in this one too. But it would be kind of weird that if he would be like the very first villain in this game, because he was kind of a big deal in the first two and I got stuck on a whole car and a wall. But yeah, like I do find that kind of weird that they're pitching as the first one, so... Hey, that was cool.
I can't say I'm surprised. You should really review your security.
That was fun. I think I actually just got hit, but...
I've seen trees with faster reflexes. Something tells me this wasn't part of the plan.
Oh, Poison Ivy's talking. Oh, good for her.
Well, that's made things a little more interesting.
Oh, there she is.
Sir, Batman, he's here.
Were you expecting to find me, Batman? I'm afraid I must disappoint you. Take a look at the chamber. I want you to know the fear that is coming.
Listen up, Bat Freak. We're walking out of here, nice and slow. You try anything stupid, I'll blow her brains out.
Dude, that's Poison Ivy.
But only
pretty sure you can't do that.
No! No! No!
Nothing like a little natural immunity.
Interesting. She's not even known for her conservativeness, has she?
Why did Scarecrow lock you up?
No, hello.
Tell me.
And what if I don't want to?
Then I burn every plant in Gotham.
It started with a meeting.
What meeting?
Everyone was there. Penguin, Two-Face, Riddler, even poor Harley. Scarecrow said he had a plan. That together we could take you out, and Gotham would be ours.
Over my dead body.
I believe that was the idea. I told him that I wasn't interested in his pathetic human games. And when I came to, I was locked up in that room. It's such a shame that his vile toxin has no effect on me. Nature always wins.
Kinda like the thirst?
Will he ever learn?
You're coming with me.
You only had to ask. What's wrong?
Batman has fighting sense.
Go, go, go! We got the target, sir. He's cornered. Don't move!
Are you sure it's him?
Confirmed, it's Batman.
Sir, that tank they have backing them up is unmanned.
Good.
I thought this would be tough. All it took was one.
Let's see. Is that what I was wanting to do? Oh, apparently it is. Those are beanbag rounds.
Batman, I've spotted six more unmanned tanks moving to Chinatown. They'll be there any second.
Okay. I'm guessing they're coming to me then? Or am I going to them? Oh, okay, they're there.
Batman,
feel like I'm playing World of Tanks. Well, when I signed up for a Batman game, I was kind of hoping for the Batman, not his mobile, but, you know, whatever. I guess being a tank is cool. Even if you are Batman. I guess even Batman loves tanks. And he doesn't love a good tank every once in a while. Alright, so... can I not get out right now, or... oh, hey, I can do first person view, that's kind of cool. Hang on. I know I'm missing something. Oh, okay, there's a quest marker there. Fair enough. I'm just blind, as usual.
The master of understatement, as ever.
Here, sit in my roller coaster ride chair.
Where those tanks are coming from?
I'm tracking several transport helicopters moving into the city. There are more on the way.
Activate the Batmobile weapon diagnostics. It's time to go to war.
Do you want to start a war, Batman? Do you wanna? Run battle mode weapon energy system? Okay. I don't know, I guess I'm trying to figure this thing out for a while. You know what, guys? I think...
miss all this? I'll take my chances with Scarecrow.
I think, on that note, I'm pretty sure this game auto-saved like the last one, that at least I hope it does. So, I think I'm gonna call that an episode. I know it's probably gonna be a shorter one. So, anyway, I kinda wanna get a feel for the game, and... kinda gauge how this is gonna work. As far as trying to feel out the time system and whatever. So, but I'm looking forward to playing through this game, and we'll see where this goes. Like I said, I'm going to try to not talk during cutscenes. It's going to be really hard not to because of my personality and having to make a comment about everything. It was actually really hard to bite my tongue for a lot of that. But I think we'll be all right. If it comes down to it, I might just talk over cutscenes if I just can't resist the urge. I'll try not to take away from any of the important cutscenes as far as anything that might be, like, emotionally driven or, you know, what have you. But anyway, I think I'm going to call this an episode. And, yeah, so we will see you guys next time on this Arkham Knight playthrough. I'm Mike Daniels, and we'll see you later.